much, Buffy. Yeah, here we are again. Thank you for being here or there or whatever you are watching us online. And we go with the second film that we are premiering today in our first feature competition. It's the film Resurrection that we're gonna screen at 9 at Solaris. And we also have a wide representation of the film here. We're really happy about that, as we have the filmmaker and the main actors here. Let's try to say the names because I'm not really used to talking Flemish. So we have here Christoph Horner.
Very good.
Yeah. Johannes Lacy.
More or less, okay.
Not that lazy, but okay. And Jus Deshave.
Fine.
okay. And well, it's kind of fun because we just introduced Bingo, whose director has a wide background in editing, and also Christoph Horner has been working with few directors also editing. No?
Yeah.
We're working with Miroslav
Slavatsky.
It's also difficult to say. In his previous short film before doing The Tribe.
Yeah. Actually, I also did a version of The Tribe.
Okay.
As an editor, but with
you also, but you.
But he's a good friend of mine, and we met at the Berlinale, where we were with our first short films in competition there.
Okay.
And since then, we showed each other our works and commented. And at one point, he showed me a version of Nuclear Waste, and I didn't want to give him feedback. I just edited his short film.
And microphone.
Okay, that's things of being streaming. That sometimes you forgot the sound. Are we becoming viral because of this? Not yet. Okay, we were discussing that you have some background in edition because you work with this Soprano director, but also you mostly have a career based on short films. I remember you were with Empire here in Tallinn and many other festivals. And so you have had this combining point of view as a filmmaker and editor.
Yeah.
How that helped to build up this story?
This story was written before all the short films. Actually.
Wow.
I wrote it in 2003, so that's like 14 years ago. And I wrote some other feature scripts as well in that period. But I realized that nobody would give me money for a feature film unless I made a short film first. So I, that's why I did a series of short films before I could get enough confidence to attract producers to finance the bigger stuff. But now I have like 3 scripts ready that I just can give to producers and say, let's.
Nice.
What do you think?
Well, no, actually, it's. Complex film for being financed, maybe.
Yeah,
because
absolutely.
It's not only the style, which is it doesn't seem to be made by a debutant,
yeah.
I have to say, but also because of the topic.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, if I have to describe the film in a couple of lines, I would say that it's a beautiful, contemplative, and maybe low budget. Big reflection about how to make decisions in life, all surrounded by a really nice nature.
Yeah, how do we deal with the cruelty of man and civilization?
Yeah,
that's set in.
You put
nature.
Both characters in, and pretty sure we're gonna discuss with you about that. You put the characters in a really crucial moment that they have to make hard decisions.
Yeah.
But also, you manage to. Put it in the way that it's the audience who has to decide.
Yeah, absolutely. The cinematic graphic expression, the images are expressing the ideas behind the narrative, but it's also the rhythm. The rhythm is slow, contemplative, and the reason I did that is because the audience has time to feel and to think and to reflect on what is happening. So
you are leaving space for the audience
to
develop in the story.
I think it's better to give time to the audience so they can participate actively not easy because everything is nowadays very closed and all the answers are normally given away in a script or in a movie. But I, for me, it was important that when the film is finished, that people, you know, think the whole time while they see the film, and afterwards as well. When the film is finished, they are left alone with a lot of questions, and they have to figure out themselves what it all means.
Yeah.
So for me, the catharsis of the film is happening when the film is already over in the bodies of the viewers.
Yeah, we don't want to reveal a lot of the
yeah.
story. Because they have to go and see it.
Yeah, they have to go.
But I have to say that this was one of the points that we most we were discussing in the film committee,
yeah.
Like not the morality of the story, because it don't underline any point, but the ethical position that you as an audience has to take,
yeah.
And it put you in a difficult situation.
Well, the film goes against the mainstream thinking of what people
yeah.
would do in such a situation,
yeah, yeah.
which is to reject or to you know, put someone who did a bad thing into jail, and then the problem is solved.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't believe that is the solution. So
we live in a society that is like rejecting responsibility.
Rejecting responsibility, and the whole civilization is like based with subjects that it's been thought out in a problem and a solution to that problem. And I don't think it's that simple. It's more complex. It's you know, it's we should. In my film, it's more about embracing. The other one, embracing humanity, if you will, and I know that goes against our reason, probably.
Yeah, and this story and this controversial position have been wonderfully developed by the two actors we have here with us and in the main roles. And Jules, you one day you were living in an isolated house. In a
yeah.
wonderful nature, and then one day you, it seems that you have not seen a lot of people for a long time,
no.
And one day you open the door, and it's that young guy in front of your, the gate of your house.
Yeah.
So, how do you react? How you?
How do I react?
Like this,
right? the difficulty and at the same time the beauty of the way Christoph wanted to show things is time. As he just told you, time also for the audience to fill in what's going on in the image, and not commenting it and not cutting it away. But that means as an actor. That you need to be there, and one of my professors at school told me that acting is thinking, and it's what's going on in the head of the guy, and not commending it, but just doing it, just thinking it, and then a camera can stay on the face, on his face or on mine, and the audience fills it in. But it's quite difficult. not to commend, not to start, do it badly, but even if you do it well, just to stay, to watch, to see, and let the camera roll, and then, yeah.
Yeah, actually, since this first encounter, this
yeah.
surprise meeting in the door, you show, both characters show like really initial trust, but yet maintaining the distance.
Yeah.
And so it's a kind of thin line
yeah.
that you were keeping the almost the whole film until it developed. But how can you arrive to that strange chemistry? Because you were making a lot of rehearsal before,
yeah.
you live for a time in a house alone.
No, I think the main work and the most difficult work was Christophe knew